about the cells I did the number 18, so I built a new one, also exposed, so I can continue measuring its performance open. The one I showed previously with water running pretty well, an oscillator, and I have been measuring the voltage and current, and it goes up and down. I mean, it goes down, then add water, it goes up. Water with alum, that cell, this cell, keep it open, pretty bright. They're running about 5. This, I think, is running at 13 milliamps. This is at 5, between 8 and 5 milliamps. Same here. I open it to see what's going on. This is one flaw in my design, by the way. When I put the 3 cells together like that, sometimes the carbon, the crystal grows and cross and jump in short circuit the cells, either from the top or from the bottom. So this design is interesting, but one has to be careful because the crystal grows and shorts everything out. This cell here, again, I showed previously, I'm still testing. I put an oscillator now, separate the oscillator so I can carry around. But anyway, here's my next test. I decided to take my thin sheets of magnesium, very thin. If they corrode pretty fast, right? So this is the way, you know, the previous, now crystal better 1, 2, 3. I think I showed that, how I use this as my testing base. So I decided to do the same here. I cut those magnesium. I sand it off, I polished, not this side, but this side, and all 3 cells, and then I pour silica, sodium silicate, and then the top of that I put it iron pyrite. I grounded my iron pyrite rock. For those that don't know what iron pyrite is, bear with me for a second. Oops, forgive me for that. So this is a rock of iron pyrite. That's how it comes. And I'm showing under the light this iron pyrite rock. So I break this with a hammer, and then I grinding down with a cheap $10 grinder. Those for coffee machine grinders. It works pretty well. So this iron pyrite in this format, by the way, I got this from Mini Me Geology, pretty cool. So I power my iron pyrite, as you can see here, in this power format. And so I pour, you can still see some of the wetness of the sodium silicate there, and I pour this dust, iron pyrite, on top of it. And because these cells here is basically carbon silica, no alum, and magnesium surrounded by iron pyrite, in my theory is iron pyrite would kind of protect the magnesium. So I decided to do a base test with a very thin layer of a magnesium, which is here. It's like less than 1/10 of a millimeter. And now they will corrode away in a day or two. So, and I'm going to use this copper board that I also shown in previous experiments, and I, you know, as you can see, it's, you know, pretty dirty by now, but I'll clean this up and I'll put those cells there. But one of the things that I want to do first right away is let's measure voltage between that and a copper ring. So I'm going to put my meter here at the voltage scale, which is 0 now. I'm going to connect the magnesium to the positive terminal. I don't want to destroy my sample. It's so fragile. It's not 100% dry yet. And the negative terminal of my meter will be... let's bring the meter closer so we can all can see. So negative, and let's see if I have any voltage reading. So I'm just going to see it there on the top of it. Okay, just sitting there, no pressure of any kind, and it's already giving me over 1 volt. And I expected that, actually. And once I put carbon, we're probably going to go to 1.5 up to 1.7 volts. But what I did not expect is, in that state, if I change to amp meter, no moisture, just the silica dry, no water, I already have half a milliamp. And it's going to grow to over a milliamp, actually. So if I let it sit like this, without any pressure, any humidity, the silica is drying. You know, I'm going to show the resistance. It's in mega ohms, the resistance between the magnesium, the top of that surface of the iron pyrite. We're talking mega ohms. And mega ohms, I'm still producing over half a milliamp. And it's interesting, it grows only when you use it. If I just connect and let it rest and connect again, it will drop. So it actually likes it. I'm pretty sure this magnesium here is not being corroded. It's not, there's no water, just silica. Well, there's 40% of the water from the silica. It's drying out. For certain, it could become glass. And just copper, magnesium, iron pyrite. I'm absolutely puzzled by this. Let me show the change this to resistance so we can see what we're talking about here. So I'm changed to resistance. Unchanged, just like we saw it. Right? It's showing mega ohms, 4.6 mega ohms. That is extremely puzzling. The internal resistance of this battery is gigantic, and yet it produces 1.5 volts and almost a milliamp of voltage, and it's going to grow. No water, silica is drying. Don't know what to say, guys. Something strange about iron pyrite. So anyway, my exercise here is to do this here and have 3 cells and then let it run. Curiosity, just let it do here. It's like 1 milliamp now already. So let's quickly change to the other cell there, last cell. Let's first measure the resistance. So change the resistance. I'm going to change this to the last cell over there. And by the way, it doesn't corrode anything on the copper. So I'm going to touch there, sitting there, and it's again showing the 4.something mega ohms. As you can see here, mega ohms. Let's measure voltage. And again, another mystery. Magnesium is not the positive terminal. Actually, no, hold on. Magnesium always is the negative terminal in my cells. That's correct. So that's okay. And then now let's put it in milliamps. Yeah. And as you can see, it starts growing as you start using it. Just for the sake of time is running out, I'm going to come back to the first cell. See what is the running current again. Just for the sake of completeness. And as I said, it drops. So when you don't use it, it drops. Let me disconnect. I'm going to disconnect. So I disconnect it. I'm going to connect it again. It's almost dry by now. About 10 seconds. And it goes up. Okay? This is extremely puzzling. I hope somebody can give a light about what's going on here and how can you use this for better.